Welcome, SOR race fans. I'm Paco Luis Calderon for Racetracks at 21st Century Faux, and this is the opening round of the 98 kart series at simracingonline.net. We are at Long Beach, and these cars are a handful. And my broadcaster partner in the booth tonight is Luke Walsh. Luke Walsh, are you there, bud? Looks like Luke is getting ready to settle in the chair here momentarily. We're just hitting qualifying now. These guys got 15 minutes to try to set the quickest time and capture that pole position. We see Kell Stenbeck with the top time in practice going around on the track now. Looks like we have 12 drivers on the field tonight. We're hoping for a little bit more of a field, but it's the first round of the series. I'm sure people are still recovering from the holidays. There you see some traffic allowing Stenbeck through. It's going to be real tricky here in these cart vehicles. You see Stenbeck getting all over the place, loose and into the wall. See who else is on circuit now. Let's ride along now with Jordan Weeks. And please forgive me if I mispronounce some of these names. I'm sure Luke will holler at us when he gets settled in the chair. Right now we're taking a look at Weeks. It looks like Sammy Lee Leinonen with the Flying Fins has gone ahead and set an early time of a 53.0. Let's see if Weeks can top that time. Weeks in with his first flying lap of a 53.7, so he's about half a second off, a little over, about 7/10 of a second off the pace there from Samuel Lee. We saw some pretty quick times. Now we've got Samuel Lee with a 52.3. Pete Enders currently in your second spot with the 52.8, I believe. A bit of a moment there as the guys try to make their way through traffic in qualifying. Luke, are you with me yet, bud?
I'm here. I'm just getting loaded up. Sorry.
No problem.
I'll be on in a sec.
Taking a look at Anders Nilsson, who has jumped into the second position now with a 52.6. Everybody still chasing Samuli Leinonen of the Flying Fins. Anders with Team GTK. Take a look at the number six qualifiers thus far, Matt Strand. Satellite Racing. Brand currently looking to improve on a 53.4. Oh, he's got some traffic up in front. Not sure who that was. Comes to the line with a 53.6, so no improvement there for Strand. Now let's take a look at George Talbot. George Talbot with 05 Motorsports. Oh, bit of a moment there for George. He will start with a fresh ride from pit road. Take a look now at Teemu Toika. Toika, Leinonen's teammate with the Flying Finns, struggling this far with a 56-0. Oh, and losing it there into the turn one complex. You saw Mohammed Patel earning a 53-1, currently sitting in the 8th qualifying position. Patel, an independent runner, and thus far, your top independent qualifier. This guy's got a little bit more than half distance left in this short 15-minute qualifying session. Patel will be looking to put that ride a few more spots up the grid if he can.
Patel up to third with that lap. Big improvement. He was down in eighth, I think, before.
Yes, he was, Luke. And of course, that's Luke Walsh that y'all are hearing in the broadcast booth. This is the SimRacingOnline.net opening round of the 98 Kart Championship. We're at Long Beach. Luke, how are you doing tonight, bud?
I'm very good, thank you. Yourself?
Pretty good. Let's take a look now at Peter Enders. Let's see if he's on circuit. Yes, he is there. Everybody, of course, still chasing Samuli Leinonen of the Flying Finns. And there's a bit of a moment, almost collects somebody that just goes by there.
Very close. It was a big moment. It was lucky that he didn't end up coming back onto the racing line sooner. He had three more cars coming from him.
Looks like Leinonen, your current pole position holder, is back on the circuit. Let's switch our focus to him, see if he can prove on that 52-2-4-9 that he has set early on in this qualifying session. Cones there down the start-finish straightaway. I'm sure the corner workers will be looking for an opportunity to dash out and clean off that from the track surface and get that way cleared. It's not really in the racing line, but still, it is a distraction for the driver, so they will be looking to clear that as quickly as they can. Leinonen coming up on some traffic, though, as he gets towards the end of this lap. Got the tight hairpin to negotiate. Gets on the gas hard. He might get a little bit of a tow here as they head towards the start-finish straightaway. No improvement, though, for Leinonen as he crosses the line. Some 3/10 slower than his best time.
Peter Enders ahead of him, of course. He's second at the minute, chasing down Samuli Leinonen's time.
Go ahead and shift our focus to
as long as he can.
we'll go ahead and shift our focus to Enders. Enders, I'm sure, will do no favors for Rantanen as far as letting him through. Enders with the Atlantic Racing Team, of course, teamed up with Jordan Weeks, who we saw were watching just a little bit earlier. Enders with a 54-2 through some traffic, so no improvement there. And of course, Rantanen didn't get around, and I missed it. Luke, did Enders let Rantanen through?
Yeah, he pulled over to the right on the way up to the hairpin, signaled him through.
Well, this is I guess he's looking to study some lines maybe from Rantanen and see if he can maybe make an improvement here. There's only about a little more than 3.5 minutes left in this qualifying session, and with a 52-second lap time for the pole, these guys are looking at three, maybe four laps left.
Lining them around again with no improvement. Very brave on that last lap, taking a lot of curbs and on a couple of... Oh, he's gone wide on the first corner. Back to the pits.
I wonder, we'll see here shortly, if that bothered Enders at all. He looked a little loose going in through a couple of those corners in the first sector. A little bit of a wide line there through the hairpin. And again, no improvement for Enders. He seems to be about 2 to 4 tenths lower than Rantanen with each circuit that he makes. We've got, I was going to say Enders is a little bit under through the first sector. We've got Talbot up into your third position now. Let's go ahead and take a look at Talbot. Talbot is on pit road. So let's go to your fourth qualifier now. Muhammad Patel, just a minute and 50 seconds left in this qualifying session. Patel should be able to get at least two more laps in, though. Oh, and Patel moving up into your second position with a 52-3 in front of Enders and Talbot. Once again, please forgive us, or more specifically myself, for any mispronunciations of last names. I'm not the best at figuring it out. Just a good old boy from Texas. And we say things a little redneckish from time to time.
That was surrendering his line there through the last section to Oliver Brandt. Looks like he's going to be going for another hot lap for the end. He's only going to be able to fit one more in. He's into the wall. Looks like that's the end of Patel's qualifying session.
Pretty good though for an independent driver, Luke. How important is that for somebody that's an independent, maybe looking for a teammate to qualify himself up into your second position?
Well, he's in this series. Patel is a independent driver, but he's a very talented driver. He's been around with SRO from the start, and he's if anybody watching the broadcast has ever watched any of the Formula One championships on YouTube and such, he's a common driver in that. So he does have a lot of talent, especially with open wheelers.
We shift focus now to Demi Leinonen of the Flying Finns, your current pole sitter. Time has expired, but if he got across the start-finish line before the time expired, he may be able to finish and complete this lap. We'll have to see if he makes it all the way around or not.
Stenbeck's just gone up into third position.
Leinonen will dive into the pits. He is satisfied. He's got his pole position. Start out this series at SRO at Long Beach. This is the 98 carts. We'll take a quick 5-minute warm-up. The guys will once the server pushes forward, and then it will be on to the race. Let's go through the grid, Luke, and you can give me your thoughts on some of these drivers. I'm not familiar with all of them. Samuel Leinonen setting the pole, starting out in front of Mohammed Patel and Kjell Stenbeck with a hot lap late in the session to capture the final podium spot as far as the qualifying goes.
Yeah, the result's fairly predictable as in terms of positions go. I was expecting Patel and Talbot to be up there and at the top of the grid, but I'm fairly unaware of some of the drivers. I haven't seen their names around before, so I'm on a learning curve as well as to the speeds of certain people. So, but it's gonna be a very very difficult race around this track, as it's a sub 1 minute lap in a 60 minute race, and it should have some good racing.
Well, there's certainly not a lot of room for error with all these concrete barriers around this street circuit here at Long Beach. A couple of passing opportunities. Where do you think is the best opportunity to make a pass here?
The best opportunity should be down the back straight. As you come onto the home straight, obviously you've got the hairpin, so you're not going to have a brilliant opportunity going down into the first corner. But down the back straight, you should see most of the passing.
Looking at some of the rest of the qualifying field, Talbot in fourth, Weeks in fifth, Strand in sixth, Brandt, another independent in seventh. We got a good mix of the teams, as we've got the Flying Finns up front, an independent team GTK, 05 Motorsports Atlantic Racing Team Satellite, and then the teammates start repeating down through the order. So it looks like a good mix with the teams. Doesn't look like any team is going to be dominant as far as two drivers go.
No, you're right. It is fairly spread out.
I believe I didn't see his time. Sergio Salsa of the Atlantic Racing Team, Jordan Weeks' teammate, down in your 12th position. Now, I believe he is one of the current champions, is he not?
I'm not completely sure. Are you saying about the Formula BMWs?
Yes, I believe it was one of the other series at SRO. Do you think that's just a lack of prep time for Salsa?
It could be. I was watching the lower half of the times, and I think he was a couple of seconds off the pace. So you never know. It's a long race. He could always come in with consistency, because these cars are very difficult to drive, especially around this track. Like you said, there's not a lot of room for error, so.
I imagine
maybe
we will
go for a slow and steady approach.
And I imagine we'll have quite a bit of attrition, or hopefully not, but probably a few boo-boos that will have to get repaired in the pits. And of course, that's going to cost a lot of time to get repairs done.
Yeah, and I mean, you spend too long in the pits, you can easily go a lap down and get in a lot of traffic, so strategy plays a lot in this race.
Now we take a look at your Formula BMW champion, Sergio Sousa, currently with a time in warm-up of, 56.8, so he's still getting familiarized with these carts and looking to make his way up the field if he can. All right, we've got about a minute left in this warm-up. Shift focus to Patel. He runs it deep into a corner. He's going to have to back out of it. One of the few escape roads here on the circuit. Decides to head back to the pits. Seconds remaining. We shift focus to George Talbot coming out of pit road. Of course, the session will expire here momentarily, and we will go on to your race. And once again, if you're just joining us out there at Sim Race TV, this is the SimRacingOnline.net opening round of the 98 kart series at Long Beach. The session has expired. These guys got 30 seconds to join the grid, and then it will be off to the races. Now, Luke, I forgot to double check the rules on this series. Will these guys be doing a standing start, or are they going to be doing a pace lap? Do you know?
I think that this series is a standing start as far as I'm aware.
So we could have quite a bit of mayhem. And the race is underway. It looks like they are going to do a siding lap.
I'll quickly check on the rules.
Guys make it their way around on this siding lap. Luke Walsh will be checking the rules, see if they will come to a stop and do a standing start. I imagine they will keep going once they come out of the hairpin, though. We will double check for you, though, as they make their way around. We currently have our focus on your pole setter, Samuli Lainanen of the Flying Finns.
Yeah. We'll be seeing a manual double file rolling start in this race.
So you have it, official word.
As you said, if we had a standing start, we could see a lot of carnage. Especially the amount of torque that these cars produce.
I did take a car around in some offline practice session, and I will say they are a handful on the throttle.
Definitely.
As Lainanen hits the final hairpin here, everybody will get lined up now. It's Lainanen darting in front of Patel and then Stenbeck. And they are coming to a stop, Luke.
Rules must have changed, because I just went and checked before, and George must have specified otherwise in the chat before the race, because he will have been telling the rules to the drivers.
And there's the green light. Linen gets a fairly good start, as does Patel. Well, now it looks like we're doing another siding lap, so some technical issues, everything hoping to get sorted here on the server. Now it looks like they will do their flying start when they come to the end of this lap, I imagine.
Yeah, it looks like the server must have been set to a warm-up lap, and then they stand in start. But obviously, they're going around now to do a manual double foil.
Once again, let's go through the starting order. We've got Linen out in front of Patel, Denbick in third, Enders in fourth, Talbot in fifth. Then it's Weeks, Strand, and Brandt in front of Nielsen, Toika, Dobolewski, Phillips, Nickel, and rounding out the field, Sergio Sousa. Linen in again through the final hairpin. We're getting ready to go live now. This is the opening round of the 98 Kart Series at SRO. They're running at Long Beach.
Race is underway. Mohamed Patel's got a good start.
Yeah, he thought about making a move there early on. Runs it in a little bit narrow into one. Has to adjust his line a little bit. Linen appears to be taking it fairly easy at the front. These guys got an hour-long race. They don't want to get in trouble early on. So far, it looks like a fairly clean start. Looks like we've got somebody running for position there in the background. Let's shift now to the seventh position. That's Nielsen. Nielsen being passed, it looks like.
Nielsen slowly nudging Sobolewski's wheel through the airfield.
Now Brandt looking up the inside there on Nielsen, can't get it done. Let's go back up front and take a look at the leaders. Finding him getting away early, or trying to. Patel is hanging on though.
Enders looking up the inside of Staubach.
Go ahead and shift our focus to Stenbeck. Enders trying to pressure. Looks like Strand has had a moment, has dropped back to 14th. We didn't see what happened.
No, he's in the pits. Must have had an incident with the wall.
We've got Linen out front of Patel. Those two are fairly close. And about half a second behind them, it's Stenbeck and Peters, or Peter Enders, rather. And about another 3 or 4 tenths behind them, it's Talbot and Weeks, putting all kinds of pressure on Talbot, it looks like.
Talbot's hit the wall.
Oh, no. Talbot has hit the wall, dropped to 6th. Let's see if he comes into the pits. We shift our focus to George Talbot.
He's into the pits.
He's into the pits. Let's go back up to the leaders. And I'm not sure if Patel got a bad run out of the hairpin, but it looks like Linen has put a little bit of a gap between himself and Patel. Gap sitting at around half a second. Linen is definitely not shy from using those curbs, Luke.
He's taken a lot of them. He's been very brave. Also, Enders is getting very close to Stenbeck through the last sector, but he can't take advantage of it coming out the hairpin. Stenbeck's just getting on the throttle a lot earlier and pulling away from him down the main straight.
A little bit of an aero setup difference there between Stenbeck and Enders. Let's go ahead and shift our focus to Peter Enders. See Stenbeck in the yellow car just in front. Looks like Richard Sobolewski has already gotten up to sixth position. I believe he started down in 8th or 9th spot, so he has gained a couple of spots.
Got a lot of distance to make up if he wants to make any more positions. He's 4 seconds behind the next position, Jordan Weeks.
Jordan Weeks trying to hang on to Enders. Was able to get around and pressure Talbot into a mistake and get around him. Let's see if Weeks is able to catch up to Stenbeck and Enders here. It looks like he's maintaining distance for the time being. Oh, and it looks like we may have a moment with Soysa. Or not. He has gotten himself up into your 11th spot, though. Oh!
Deuce is off.
And a real tricky moment coming back onto the racing line there between Soysa and Toika. Or I think it may be Salsa. I'm not sure, again, on the pronunciation on some of these last names. Let's go back up to the leader, Leinonen. Still out front of Patel, but Patel has closed ground on Leinonen.
Stenbeck's in the wall. Stenbeck's lost the wheel.
Oh, no.
Bit too eager on the throttle through the first corner, and he just lost it. Couldn't hold on. Now that promotes Peter Enders up to third.
It looks like Kjell Stenbeck out of this race. Tough break. We talked during qualifying about how little room for error there is, Luke, and that's the penalty that you pay if you get it wrong.
Yeah, there's so much talk in these cars that you lose your concentration for a second and take advantage of the throttle and you're in a wall. Got to be on it constantly.
We're still following this battle at the lead between Leinonen and Patel. Leinonen looked like he was set to maybe get away from Patel, but now getting a little squirrely on the throttle is Leinonen, and Patel is right here up under his wing, setting himself up for a good position coming out of the final hairpin. Looks like Ryder got a little bit better drive, though, out of the hairpin there as Patel spins him up. I thought maybe Patel was going to get a good run on him down the start-finish straightaway, but if you're going to make a move into turn one, Luke, you got to do it real early on during the straight.
Yeah, I don't think anybody's going to have much chance of getting past anyone down the main straight. The amount of difference coming out of the hairpin, if you're ahead of someone, the time on the throttle, it's very difficult to get a run.
Well, Patel really stuck his nose up under the wing of Leinonen, but just could not get the same drive out of that final turn that Leinonen did. Looked like Leinonen was in trouble, but now with that mistake from Patel,
we have Jordan
now
Weeks
back up to
problem.
A little bit more than a second. I'm sorry, what was that, Luke?
We have Jordan Weeks retired from the race with a suspension problem. I didn't quite see what happened there.
Oh, no. That's going to move Sergio Sosa.
On replay, we've got Weeks coming through the first sector. Just loses it on acceleration into the wall.
So already we have two drivers out. We're only about 10 minutes in to this hour-long race. That's going to move Sergio Sosa up into your ninth position. Jim Dickel just behind Sosa now.
We have another retirement, Richard Sobolewski suspension.
Wow, so they are dropping like flies here at Long Beach. The concrete barriers not overly friendly.
This combination isn't for the faint-hearted.
Gift our focus back up to the leader, Dami Leinonen of the Flying Finns, with almost a second and a half gap over Patel now. Do you think Patel burned up his tires trying to catch back up to Leinonen, or do you think maybe just a little shaken with the confidence on the throttle after spinning him up out of the hairpin?
I think he may have thought to himself that it's an hour race and he may just be trying to pace himself and not burn himself out too early.
Oh, and Leinonen runs it real deep into the hairpin. That's going to let Patel catch back up.
I think Patel followed him there. Seemed from on board with Enders, it seems as if Patel ran quite wide as well.
Yeah, and Enders is catching up to these guys. We shift our focus now to Peter Enders in your third position. Looked like he was going to drop back a little earlier. Was fighting with Kell Stenbeck for quite some time. And now as these guys in front of him start to make some mistakes on the tires, Enders is closing in. So we've got about a 2.5 to 3 second gap from first to third. Are you surprised that we have such a close competition on a tight street circuit such as this?
It is surprising to see drivers quite as close to each other. You'd expect them to, especially with this type of car, they're not very easy to be consistent with, so you'd expect people to band out from each other. But with the circuit only being, a sub-1 minute circuit, drivers will get quite bunched up.
And Enders there getting held up a little bit by traffic.
Leinonen making his way past Jim Dickel.
And Leinonen again spinning up the tires under acceleration. He's going to have to be real mindful of that if he wants to make it, if he wants to keep the car on the circuit. While these guys sort themselves out a little bit, let's shift focus to some of our other competitors here today. In your fourth spot, Anders Nielsen with Team GTK. Kind of just running out there by himself, Luke. Looking pretty smooth, though. He's got traffic up in front of him.
Yeah, I think there's a few drivers today who you don't want to try and push these cars too far and end up with a DNF, so they're pacing themselves. I heard a couple of the drivers talking earlier on as well about the tyre wear. That even with the hards on this track, the tyres do wear quite fast, so it's a good choice to try and be consistent.
Now let's shift our focus to your fifth position, Oliver Brandt. Brandt, another independent, doing a pretty good, making a good solid effort here, currently running in your fifth spot.
Just had another retirement, that's our fourth retirement of this race, Nick Phillips.
The 14 star, and a huge moment there from Brandt. He catches the wall a little bit. Now he tries to scrub his tires a little bit down the back straightaway. I didn't see if he caught any damage there on the front arrow. Looks like he's going to stay out, though. Check back in with the top three. Shift our focus now to Mohammed Patel, who has again caught himself up to Sami Laitinen. The Enders in the background, not too far behind this duo, but Patel again within a second of the leader.
A very good run out of the pack in there.
Laitinen seems to be getting away from Patel down the straightaway a bit. Different aero setup, you think?
Possibly. I think that's more the accordion effect out of the slow corners. Because obviously with the torque, you have to be very careful on the throttle. You can't floor it straight away. So, Patel's locked his tyres. He's into the wall. Carrying on though. Doesn't seem as if he's caught any damage.
He got quite a good run there on Laitinen and down the back straightaway. I think he was just trying to pressure, but maybe got a little bit of the aero wash.
Yeah, it looked as if he was getting very close to the back of Laitinen, and so he had to lock his brakes to avoid him.
Did a good job not to sustain any damage.
I think he's lucky that the angle that he hit the wall at, if he would have hit it with his front corner, it probably would have been a pit stop for him.
See how he makes it through this time. No troubles the next time around. But you see Enders there a lot closer now. Patel kind of has his own accordion effect going, Luke. He drops back a little bit, then catches back up, and then drops back again. And I'm sure that's not the way he's wanting his race to go, but I imagine he'll get it figured out. He's still got about two-thirds of race distance left to get it sorted.
Yeah, I'm sure he's still trying to find his rhythm at the minute. It'll be when he's behind Laitinen, and he'll be desperately wanting to find a way past, but this track doesn't give him much opportunity to. He's had a big moment there for the first sector.
Yeah, he did. Enders getting a run down the back straightaway now. Oh, Patel tries to fight back, but can't get it done. And Enders will take your second position now from Mohammed Patel.
Now, Oliver Brandt is out of the race. Oliver Brandt is retired. He's lost the wheel by the looks of it.
and we shift our focus to Enders. Muhammad Patel nowhere to be seen. I'm not sure what's going on with Patel. We're now showing Anders Nilsson in your third position.
Peter Enders into the pits now. Also George Talbot making his way in. But this may be the first round of tyre changes.
Enders going for an early pit strategy. You still see Leinonen making his way around, having some difficulty getting through that final hairpin, though. Lining and just getting around Strand there. Strand back up into your eighth position, but the last running car on the circuit, some two laps behind the leader.
Strand had trouble early on with damage. Tallies into the wall. Oh. That was car looks very badly damaged. I'm not sure what happened there.
Looks like he's missing his rear wing and just kind of creeping his way along to get try to find his way back to pit road if he can. A problem for Patel. We saw him drop off earlier from Enders. Wasn't sure what happened. But now it looks like he's having all kinds of issues.
On the replay, it looks as if he went straight into the wall going down the main straight. So I'm not sure what happened there. His wheel may have turned off or something similar, because it didn't seem as if it was a driver-induced leak.
So Patel hits pit road. That's going to drop him down into your eighth spot behind Strand. Oh, and now he is retired from the race. Let's go back up and take a look at our leader, Sami Leinonen. Leinonen in some 36 seconds in front of Enders, but of course Enders has pitted. Leinonen has not. And again, trouble making it around that final hairpin. Those front tires are getting awfully worn. Let's take a look now at Teemu Toikka, who has made his way up into your third spot. Toikka is Leinonen's teammate, so the Flying Finns looking for the best possible start to the season as far as the team championship goes. See his teammate, Sami Leinonen, coming up behind Toikka. Your Toikka will allow Leinonen through. without any fuss. It looks like Torque is heading to the pit road. No, he's not. He just pulled over to let Lightning through. But Torque taking no chances. But with just a little more than half distance left, Luke, we've got just right at half the field.
Yeah, we also have no independent drivers remaining in this race.
Regardless, well, we still got half distance left, but the Flying Finns and Atlantic Racing Team, the only with both drivers still in the race. Let's take a look now at George Talbot in your sixth spot with 05 Motorsport. Talbot about 4 seconds behind of Sergio Bauza. This may be your closest battle on track. No, actually, it looks like we have Anders Nielsen. Let's shift our focus to fourth place, Anders Nielsen. About 2 seconds behind Team Lutoika. And now just as we shift our focus for this battle, for the final podium spot, it looks like Talbot has closed to within a second of Sergio Sousa. So Sousa having some issues as well.
Talbot's now ahead of Sousa.
Is Sousa in the pits or?
No, he's still on track. He seems to have slowed through the first section. I'm not sure whether he has a problem with his car. But he seems to I'll be sticking to the line. I think he may have damaged his car.
Currently focused on Anders Nielsen in your fourth spot, right up under the wing of Team Utoika. Utoika with the Flying Finns, Nielsen with Team GTK. They are nose to tail, coming across the start-finish line. Anders taking a look on the inside. He's going to try to fight himself for position coming into turn one. And looks like he's got the spot over Toika. So Nielsen doing a good job to muscle himself through into the final podium position. But we've still got half the race distance left to do. And it looks like we've got the leader in the pits. Actually, the lead has changed now. Peter Enders in the lead over Samuli Lininen. I think Lininen pitted and Enders was able to hop in front of him through the pit rotation. So the early pit strategy for Enders, Luke, paying off dividends.
Yeah, it will take a couple of laps now for Lininen to make his way back up to challenge Enders. Oh, and Enders in the wall.
Oh, disaster for Peter Enders with Atlantic Racing. You think that's just maybe looking in his mirrors at the wrong moment?
It must have been. He's probably seen he's got past Lining and tried to push to keep his distance and just missed his braking point.
Wow. Tough moment from Enders as he turns in just a little bit early, catches too much curb, and it throws him across the track and into the wall. Peter Enders out of the range from the lead. Samuli Lininen will take back the top spot in front of Anders Nielsen. And when Toika makes it around to the start-finish line, he will be in your third spot. We're now at the 30-minute mark, Luke. We've got seven drivers still on the circuit. That's six.
Two of which on the lead lap. It will be interesting to see if the drivers who are one lap behind can come up with a strategy to get themselves back up onto the lead lap.
And has Nielsen pitted? Do we know if Nielsen has pitted yet?
I think Nielsen did pit quite a while ago, yeah.
Okay, so we've got, looks like Leinonen's got about a 20-second gap over Nielsen now. In your second spot, we've got Team Utoika, a lap down in third, in front of George Talbot. Now, those two are on the same lap, and Talbot is about 4 seconds behind Toika. Let's go ahead and shift our focus to Leinonen's teammate, Timo Toika. He will try to maintain that gap over Talbot if he can. Then we've got Strand in your fifth position, also on the same lap, some 17 seconds arrears of Talbot. And Sergio Sousa, two laps down with some trouble that he had just recently, I believe getting his having to get his car repaired in down pit road. And Talbot, Luke, is closing that gap. I'm showing it now at about 3.5 seconds. Let's go ahead and shift our focus to George Talbot.
Yeah, he's closing the gap. He's within sight now, down this back straight.
It seems, Luke, that every time somebody gets a carrot in front of the horse, so to speak, and they start pushing it, disaster strikes. What can George do to maintain focus and hopefully avoid that big incident that knocks him out of the race?
I think the way to avoid incidents in these cars is just to focus on your own drive. So, it seems that a lot of people, like you say, have been focusing on the people ahead of them or just behind, and they've not been focusing on where they are on the track, and then slightest mistake and they're into a wall and the race is over. So I think it's important that George just focuses on his own drive, and when the pass comes, that he takes it safely.
Gap down to under 2 seconds now between Talbot in fourth and Toika, fighting for that final podium spot. I don't know that Toika is going to really fight him too hard here, Luke. I think that at this point, with all the DNFs, the Flying Finns may be thinking about team championship.
Yeah, it's the amount of time that George has just closed up and then in one lap, it looks as if Toika would probably be making himself very wide to hold George off. So, yeah, I think it would be better if Timo was to yield to him. Or that he doesn't want to end up as one of the DNFs.
We see George Talbot now within about a second of Team Utoika for the final podium spot. Still 26 minutes left in this event, though. Disaster has been all over the place, Luke, and it just seems like a lot of the drivers, like you said, shifting their focus to the other cars around them, somebody they're chasing or somebody that's chasing them, losing focus, running off the track. But I know there's a lot of disappointment that's going around down pit road now.
Yeah, well, I'm sure that a lot of the drivers in this race probably haven't been involved with races with these cars before, so they'll definitely be on a learning curve. So they'll come back next round and hopefully try and be more consistent and just try and get some points.